In-depth interview, hard-hitting highlight, and a whole lot more. Basin Gridiron.
Welcome back, everyone. I am Aaron Reynolds, and I am now joined by our Game of the Week reporter, Caleb Califano. So, of course, he was at our Game of the Week out at Midland Christian this past Friday, and it ended up being a crazy game. So, Caleb, can you kind of just walk us through how that game went, and then, of course, Midland Christian's comeback there at the end?
Well, the biggest thing I definitely think was the flow of the game. We've talked about this before. It started off really hot. Both teams scored on their first drives, and then it started to slow down a little bit. I was actually worried when I was going to go edit my highlights that I was going to miss more scores in the first half, but once I was done, I got back towards the end of the second quarter. I looked, and it was the same score from when I left. So there was a very long defensive stretch all the way towards the end of the third quarter, and then we got into the fourth, and that's when things really started to pick up. The both teams scored one after each other, and it got all the way down to the wire, and it was just this crazy game that had all these different kinds of flows to it, both offensively and defensively.
Can you kind of talk about the timing there toward the end a little bit? Midland Christian obviously scoring last, but I know you mentioned Cornerstone Christian had a chance there at the end.
They did have a chance, and it got all the way down to the last 3 minutes. They kind of went back and forth on their touchdowns, and to be honest with you, Cornerstone Christian did have a chance with 5 seconds to go, now that I remember. And the big thing is that I forgot to mention at one point was that they got 2 personal fouls on fourth down. And so they were pretty close to the red zone, and they got pushed back all the way. And I think it was around 4th and 50 towards the end of the game. Of course, Midland Christian with a big defensive pullout at the win.
Right, right. So Midland Christian obviously getting that nice win there. What were some of the positives that you saw out of Midland Christian in order to get that victory?
Well, Midland Christian definitely kept their composure this entire game. They didn't really get flustered as the game went by. You know, when you have those long defensive battles, especially in the middle of the game, that can frustrate especially a young high school team, and they didn't do that, and they picked up towards the end. And of course, once we got into the fourth quarter, that's when clutch time needs to happen, and they really did pull it through with some clutch touchdowns, both running and passing the ball.
Okay, now folks, in case you missed it, Caleb was able to interview Midland Christian head coach Greg McClendon after the game. And if you saw the live shot, it was a hurricane.
It was absolutely crazy.
So what was the weather like, and how were the teams preparing for that?
Well, believe it or not, before the game and during the game, the weather was perfectly fine. There was a couple drops in the first quarter here and there, but the weather during the game, especially towards the end, was perfect weather. Then right when the game ended is when the weather started to get really bad. And we talked to our chief meteorologist, Chase Menendez, about this. And what he told me is that the weather split in half and kind of went through the game on both sides. And towards the end, around when the game ended, then we got hit by this wall of storms. And there was lightning everywhere. And coach really wanted to keep his players off the field. And I think that's something that he really respected. He just got this big win, but he really cared about the safety of his players. So I thought that was awesome.
He got really lucky there towards
absolutely.
Okay, so whenever you got back from the game, you mentioned it was very exciting, one of our most exciting game of the weeks we've had. So can you kind of walk us through the atmosphere for Midland Christian and just what it was like out there?
Yeah, absolutely. I think it was just a classic West Texas football game. You have high energy. Every time I go to Midland Christian, they always have this great energy from their fan base. Their students were yelling and cheering. It was homecoming this time around, so of course you had that extra part to it. But the game was just a high-intensity West Texas football game that went all the way down to the wire. When you have those, it's always going to be a fun one.
Okay, Caleb, really quick, Odessa High Permian will be our next game of the week. Do you have any thoughts on that fun rivalry game?
Well, it's the classic rivalry in Odessa. You never know what's going to happen. Obviously, Permian's having a good season. Last year, I believe they won 35-9, so they want to repeat that. But with a classic game like this that's been going on for decades, you never know.
Yep, can't beat these rivalry games. Okay, thank you, Caleb. Again, that game is this Friday, and it is the start of district ball for both Odessa High and Permian. So some more on the line there. Now let's move on to some six-man football as promised. And